The more widespread various mobile devices become, the more open we are faced with the need to play back the music recorded on such devices in a small room or something like that. It is MP3 players and mobile devices that are mostly used for these purposes. And although the majority of phones come with relatively large speakers, the ringing and trembling sound during playback in a small bedroom make them hardly the best fit to these ends. The easiest and the most reliable solution to the problem could be small active speakers, or speakers with an amplifier. But then comes the issue of, say, where you get power supply from when you're out in the nature, and how to get an amplifier, and then how difficult all of this is after all. I believe that your best pick would be to assemble a simple stereo amplifier based on a TDA-1552Q microchip all by yourself. Let's look at this microchip in more detail. TDA-1552Q microchip is a two-channel amplifier of low frequency with an output of 22 watt per channel and single supply operation within a range of 10 to 18 volts. The rated load resistance for the microchip is 4 ohms, which corresponds to the resistance typical of most speakers. Although TDA-1552Q is also a good fit for 8 ohm speakers, the microchip is protected against overheating, earth ground fault and short circuit output. To assemble our amplifier, apart from the microchip itself, we would need only 4 more parts, 1 electrolyte pick and 3 film or ceramic capacitors. All we need is to connect them according to the circuit, and the amplifier is almost ready. We just need to solder the right slot for connecting the source of signal to the input, and the cords will connect on the speakers. We will use a 3.5mm stereo plug. Another thing we need to take care of is cooling. Let's screw it into the cooler case through special earrings. You can use a small aluminium plate to abstract the heat. Now we can supply power to our amplifier from any suitable power source, or if we need a mobile solution, from a small 12-volt battery, like a lead-acid battery, from an uninterrupted power supply unit, or an old laptop battery. Just for the sake of convenience, it is recommended that the circuit be placed in a small case or inside the case of one of the speakers, if the latter are factory-built.